So basically, we are given the matrix, the 2 by 2 matrix, minus 1 over 2, minus 9 over 2, minus 9 over 2, minus 1 over 2 to be equal to this. This multiplied by a diagonal matrix multiplied by this. And we are 2 to find when that same matrix is reached by 5151. That's 5151. Now, basically, the basic thing to do here is that whenever you are given a matrix A to be equal to B, D, P inverse. It means that if you are told to find A raised to power N, it's equal to B, D raised to power N, P inverse. This does the expression to use. That is now A raised to power 5151 is equal to P, D raised to power 5151 P inverse. The interesting thing about this problem is that, let me tell you something, whenever you are told to find a very big power of a matrix, the best thing to do is to diagonalize the matrix. But they have helped us to diagonalize it, they've helped us to find the eigenvectors, the eigenvalues, as well as the inverse of the, you know, the invertible matrix. So basically, this is standard for A, minus 1 over 2, minus 9 over 2, all this. Then this is the P, this P I wrote here, this is it. Then this is the diagonal matrix, then the P inverse. So you only need to confirm that the inverse of this is actually this. And that is very trivial, you can check that on your own. Now to find A, this raised to power 5151, or let me say let A be equal to that matrix, minus 1 over 2, minus 9 over 2, minus 9 over 2, minus 1 over 2. So that means we want to find A raised to power 5151. So that means A raised to power 5151 will basically be equal to P, D raised to power 5151, P inverse, which is P. That's 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, multiplying D raised to power 5151. This is not a big D, this is just minus 5 raised to power 5151. You just put minus 5 raised to power 5151. So since the power is odd, so the minus still remain 0, 0, 4 raised to power 5151. So then multiply by the inverse. Writing the inverse at the denominator, that's 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2. So what is left in this problem is just to, you know, multiply this matrix. And once you're done multiplying the matrix, we are done with the question as well. A raised to power 5151 will then be equal to now. Let me multiply this first. I have, look at what I'm going to do. This is how we multiply, then down for the first row. So 1 over root 2 multiplied by minus 5151 will just give me minus 1 over root 2. Minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by 5 raised to the power 5151. This multiplied by 0 will obviously give me 0. Now, the 1 over root 2, now I'm doing for this second column. 1 over root 2 multiplied by 0 is 0. Minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by 4 raised to the power 5151 will give me minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by 4 raised to the power 5151. So, 1 over root 2 multiplied by, now I'm at the second row, so I'll do the same thing. 1 over root 2 multiplied by minus this. Without wasting time, I'll just write it. Minus 1 over root 2, 5 raised to the power 5151. Then I have 1 over root 2 as well here, multiplied by 4 raised to the power 5151. So, then it's multiplying the inverse, which is 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2, minus 1 over root 2, 1 over root 2 as well. So I'll multiply this, just the same matrix multiplication, a raised to the power 5151 to be equal to now. Let me come back to blue pen, this row, multiply this way. So without wasting time, this will give me minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by 1 over root 2 will give me minus 1 over 2. Minus 1 over 2, 5 raised to the power 5151. Then minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by minus 1 over root 2, it will give me plus 1 over 2, 4 raised to the power 5151. Now, I need to just create a space here that can contain my matrix. So, now, the same thing I'll do for the second column. This one will obviously just follow the procedure, the normal way of multiplying, matrix multiplication. You will see what I'm doing. Minus 1 over root 2 multiplied by 1 over root 2. This one will also give me minus 1 over 2, 5 raised to the power 5151. Minus again 1 over 2, 4 raised to the power 5151. Then the denominator, the second row, I will use this time around. So minus 1 over root 2 times 1 over root 2 will give me minus 1 over 2. Then I have 5 raised to the power 5151. Then this one will also be another minus. Minus 1 over 2, 4 raised to the power 5151. Then I have minus 1 over 2 as well, 5 raised to the power 5151. Then plus 1 over 2, 4 raised to the power 5151. So you will see that 1 over 2 is common in all the rows and all the columns. I can factorize 1 over 2 at a raised to the power 5151 will then be equal to 1 over 2. Since I'm factorizing them out, then I have minus 5 raised to the power 5151 plus 4 raised to the power 5151. Then in this first row, second column, minus 5 raised to the power 5151 minus 4 raised to the power 5151. Then in this place as well, we have minus 5 raised to the power 5151 minus 4 raised to the power 5151. This is minus 5 raised to the power 5151 plus 4 raised to the power 5151. And that is actually the answer. Thank you very much.